Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see about what is incremental refresh, how it will be useful to you. Typically, let us try to understand what is incremental refresh is all about. When you have a data set, a huge data set, when you do a scheduled refresh, the entire data set will be refreshed. Like you have 10 years of data, and all this 10 years of data is refreshed every time when you do the scheduled refresh. But you want to avoid it because you have very few days of data getting updated. Say for example, last 1 month data or today's data only, you need to capture it. Only refresh whatever has changed or newly added. So this is not possible without incremental refresh. That is what we are going to do. Only update the latest and updated data. This is what incremental refresh is, and this can be achieved using when you have pro and premium per user license. Let us check it out how to configure this. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's see the requirements. As I mentioned before, you need pro or premium per user license, and incremental refresh mostly works very good with the structured and relational data source like SQL Server, SQL Database, and Azure Synapse. And once you have this data source, then you need to have create the two reserved keywords, other parameters, range start and range end. These are the reserved words for configuring incremental refresh. While doing the demo, you will understand where to create those. Then your data sources should have a query folding. I have already made a video on query folding. Just go and check it out if you are not aware what this query folding is all about. Then finally, you may think like, my data source is not SQL, so whether I can do the incremental refresh or not. Yes, you can do it. You need to do some additional custom query functions so that refresh can be used with other types of data sources, provided filters based on range start and range end. That is, you need to have a date column, and that should be capable of filtering range start and range end, right? So this is what the requirement is. Once you meet all this requirement, any one of them, once you satisfy this, then you can configure it. If someone may still not aware or understand what is incremental refresh, for them, I'm just showing it in a diagrammatic way. Like without incremental refresh, what will happen is like you have a sales table and you have scheduled refresh, right? This is in service. Your sales table will reside in on-premise or cloud, whatever, wherever. When you do a scheduled refresh, the entire table, it contains 10 years of data. The 10 years of data will be refreshed every time. When you have an incremental refresh, what will happen is like your sales table remains same, and the scheduled refresh, you will configure two tables. You are not going to create anything, just configuration will do. This historical table may contain last 10 years of data or last 5 years of data. And your another table will be created that will contain only your latest updates and new records. So history plus updates table. Then your data set will combine the result set from here, because as you can see, the last 10 years data you are not going to touch, right? It will not change, but the current year and the new records you need to refresh. So you need to refresh only this data every time when you do a scheduled refresh. That is the basic idea. So only this will happen. This will be stored only once. Once you do the deployment for the very first time in the services, only this table will take much time at the very first time. After that, you will not able to touch this one. So the new and updated data will be processed every time when you do a scheduled refresh. That is the code logic behind that. And one of the drawback is, like, once you publish it, you cannot able to download this PBIX file since the partitions are stored in the Power BI services. Let's jump into demo how to configure this. I'm in Power BI now. I do not have anything right now. It's a fresh Power BI file. Let's go and get some data. My data is in SQL Server. Let me put that. That is my local server. Then I want to import it. And I'll choose my table. My table is fact sales data, and I have customer interest. I will go to Power Query. Now this is my tables, and which table I need to configure. It should be a fact table. So fact is the table that contains all the history. You're not going to configure in dimension. In some cases you may do, but mostly the incremental refresh is meant for fact tables. So let us do this one. For this, as I said before, you need to have one date table, date column right over here. Like, I have a sale date and update date. Forget about this one. This update date is more or less same. When there is an update to this record, this will get changed. So now focus on sale date. So this sale date, based on that, we will configure, we will filter it, right? The range start and range end, we will filter it here. Let's do step by step. First step is to create two parameters. So click on manage parameters. So click on manage parameters. So this new parameter here, you need to start typing range. Put exactly same like this, range stat. Then the type should be dead time. Then the value over here is 2020. Then click on OK. Similarly, create another parameter, namely range end. Then the type 2020, and the value is going to be 31/12/2020. Okay, this is fine. So now basically we have created these two dates, and you may have a question like how it will be configured. Now this range will be filtered in the fact table, and that is what. So you may think, like, you filter only for 1 year, how the history and other things will be changed, right? The new data will be appearing. So those configurations we will do after this step. Those will be overridden at the services. These values will be overridden, right? So let us try to do the first step to filter this data based on these two range. Now go to sales date in the fact table, then choose date filters and choose between. Filter based on that parameter. This is equals parameter. This is after, or is if after or equal to. This is, can be anything. Just you can press is after or equal to range start. Then you choose the parameter. Then here is before or equal to. From the parameter, you choose range end. So this is the configuration you need to make, which meaning, like, you filtered for this particular year. Now you can see the data contains from 2021st till the December the 31st, but there is no data for 31st. That is absolutely fine. Now this is the first step you need to make. We are done with the configuration in the Power Query. And you may have a question like, what happens when you do not have a sale date? You might have connected to the integer column, the sale date key, right? So you need to create one date column here in order to configure the incremental refresh. So from the integer, you apply some mQuery to generate the sale date, right? That is the thing you need to do. Now, once you do the close and apply, let's try to load it in the Power BI desktop for the 1 year data. It is loading now. Yes, it has been loaded now. Now, once after this, you can create your reports by dragging and dropping. That is obviously you may aware. Like, let us try to create some simple report over here. By quantity, I want by product category. Let us try to view it here. And by location, I want by pie chart, the same quantity. How much quantity here? Let us do these two simple reports. This is fine. Now, where I should configure incremental refresh, that is the first step, range start and range end. Then right click on this fact table, or whichever table you want to configure incremental refresh. Then you see this incremental refresh option. So this screen will appear, and once you see here, you have configured this range start and range end in this table. That is why it is appearing. Otherwise, this option won't appear. So once you toggle in this incremental refresh, you are enabling the incremental refresh here. Then, as I mentioned before in the presentation, you need to specify the history information. Store rows where column sale date in the last 5 years or 6 years, right? You can see here, this is the presentation we have seen. Like, we have already seen here the configuration. This configuration we are trying to make here. What history table should contain? History table should contain last 5 years or last 10 years data. Then remaining things should be in this update table. That is what you are configuring here now. So in the last 5 years, I have data for 5 years only. So last 5 years, I will mention it here. Then refresh rows where the column sale date in the last. Okay, so this is your configuration. This information depends upon your business. Some business, the data will be changing. Data won't be changing more than 10 days. You will update the records for the past 10 days or monthly basis. Let us go for 30 days. The my data won't change for last 30 days. This is the mandatory fields, that is table, store in the history, then how many days you refresh should update, right? I mean, your data will get update 30 days. That's it. These are the three mandatory fields. Then these are the two optional fields. We will take it up in a separate video, that detect data changes. This is like, you don't want to update even for 30 days. If you mention some column over here, like as I mentioned before, the last sale date and last updated date, you need to choose this particular column, right? So the sale date is for filtering the range, like for incremental refresh. The update date is for change direction. So only if particular column or particular row is updated, you update only that particular row, right? Detect data changes, then do the refresh. So based on that, if you have one column, then you can choose this option, right? Then only refresh complete days. So it is not like consider the whole day. If you scheduled it for 5 a.m. or 6 a.m., it is not a complete day. So ensure that the scheduled refresh should happen considering the all day data. So these are the options. These are optional. Just leave it for now. These are three things are mandatory. Then click on apply all. So that's it from the Power BI desktop. We have already configured the incremental refresh, and let's publish this report into Power BI services and do some configuration that if required over there. So this is my sales report, and it requires Power BI Pro or Premium. So I have a Power BI per user licensing. So I will deploy it in this workspace. That is V20 incremental refresh. Once you deploy it, we can go and log in. That will redirect to our pages. There you go. We have deployment here, and you can see the refresh over here. I mean, this is the data set, this is the report, and we can go and configure the schedule refresh over here. Go to the settings, and we need to set up a gateway, all other stuffs. So once you set up a gateway over here, then obviously you will have the setup ready. Once you do the refresh, everything will be refreshed here. So this is the simple configuration. You are not going to do much over here. Everything will be configured by your Power BI services. So now the different dates, the data range that we have set in the Power Query, that will be overridden based on the setups we do in this screen, like over here, that will be managed in the Power BI services. So the year 2020 and 2020 that we have set up in the Power Query will be overridden by these configurations in the Power BI services over here. Once you enable the gateway connection, and you can schedule the refresh over here. This is already, we have seen how to schedule a refresh. It is very simple configuration. You can do it. I hope you like this video, and comment below for queries if you have. Do remember that data is your asset.